everybody, this is Tambiota, and I'm back with another Transformers video review. And the brown box can only mean one thing. You know what time it is. Thundermania time! Alright, so, yeah, let's go ahead and get this guy open. This is, if you take a look at it here, say that this is the fourth figure in the subscription service, 4.0. So we got two more figures to go, and then the seventh hidden figure. So who knows what that is so far, but this guy right here, we got Windsweeper. So this is actually a redeco or recoloring of Skydive along with an extra accessory. So let's go ahead and take this guy out. Along with his fist hand weapon, his double barrel gun, then his matrix of malice. Then underneath the foam here, we have his instructions. So get all this stuff out of the way. Like I said, we have for our weapons the Matrix of Malice, which is a gold matrix with a green gem on the inside of it, and it actually feels like it's made out of some kind of metal, because it's pretty heavy. It's got some weight to it. But yeah, and it's actually I do believe this is a MP10 sized matrix, so it'll actually go in all of those figures. The MP10, Ultra Magnus, and I do believe the new Rodimus will also fit all of these items or these matrixes. So here's his instructions, Thundermania, and then here's his bio card along with his technical data. So let's see if I can get that in there. You should be able to read that now. If not, then you can go to my Facebook. I do have pictures of this posted up there, so you can read that without any hindrance from the plastic here. So we do have his technical data, and it looks like his speed is his top attribute, which is at a 9, and then his second would be his courage, which is at an 8. Alright, so let's real quickly take a look at the figure, and it's, once again, very beautiful figure, along with the paint and the tampos and all that stuff. These are really, really, really nice figures, and this one doesn't have a super whole bunch of paint on it. Well, it does, but not as much as the other figures that we've had in this line. The whole body is basically molded out of, it looks like pretty much, yeah, the whole body is molded out of this rusted color, this rusty red color. So they did have to do some painting on the wings and on some of the forearms and some parts of the leg here. But it looks like some of the other items, like this right here, combiner port, along with some of the articulation points and such are in this tan color. So, yeah, very nice. Alright, so let's go ahead and transform this guy real quickly. Now, something that I've noticed with messing with this figure quite a bit is that he seems to have a little bit more issues with being loose, with parts being loose. I think that this mold has been used so much, I think it's starting to have some fatigue on it. The main place that I see a lot of the issues is in with the wings here, because they don't stay at all. Now when you clip them up here, then they stay, but down in jet mode, they flop around a lot. And they did use a standard head, once again. And then there's Windsweeper in his robot mode. So we have his gun that you can put in his hand. He can't really hold this accessory. I did something kind of a little cheap. I cheated a little bit. I actually to get pictures with him with his this accessory, I actually took and made this hand, and then tabbed it into his hand. And then I could actually take and put the matrix in there. Now I also had a cheat with him being able to hold up his hand, because this is like extremely loose, and if you put even this portion in there, he has problems holding it up. So you can imagine with having a metal matrix in there, how much issues you're gonna have with weight problems and stuff with that loose hand. So even with this gun, it's barely holding up. I'm pretty sure if I put this gun in this hand, then it wouldn't stay up. Oh, it's staying up. All right, well, I'm a liar, so thank you. But yeah, a lot of this stuff is really loose. Like if I, let's see what we can do here. So it's not, it can stay. It's just not super tough. Now you can go in there and you can add some floor polish if you wanted to, or whatever you like to use to tighten up joints. You can do that, and that would definitely probably help. Me, I'll just leave him alone. Just leave him like he is. Wait until we get all five pieces for that Thunder Mania. All right, so for his gun, I'm not gonna do anything with his gun. I don't know what I'm doing. So for his articulation here, I guess that's where I wanted to go. We'll go to the head. It's on a ball joint, so we got left and right, up and down. Then we have different stuff here with the ball joint. Then we have the elbow. Right above the elbow, we have the a twist. Then coming down here, we have a waist, so you can turn that, and that's actually pretty stiff. Then you come to the ball joints for the legs, for the hips, and you get all kinds of range of motion. Twist, knee is stiff because it's got a pin going through it. And so going back to his aircraft mode. I'll just really quickly do this. And then another issue that I have, okay, that goes down there, is that sometimes this doesn't want to push in all the way. So I don't know what's hindering that, but it doesn't seem to want to go in all the way. See how it pops out really easily too, I might say. It doesn't clip in and stay in. See, you push it in. Well, it's not doing it now, it's staying in, but when I bring it close, it then gets shy. So we're back into his jet mode now. So like I've said before, we have two more figures coming out in this year's Subscription Club. So I don't really know what's going to be next. I know that Bludgeon is the last part that we need for Thunder Mania. That's going to be the main central part. And then we also have Impactor, which he's another limb, but he's the only Autobot out of this whole run this year. I don't really know what's going to be next. Something kind of tells me that probably Impactor is going to be, because they want to wait till the very end to probably build or to completely build this thing. So my prediction would probably be Impactor next, and then Bludgeon last, and then whatever figure is going to come with him. And I probably assume it's going to be some kind of accessory, especially after what he's made out of. I assume it'll be some kind of figure using the groove mold, just because of what he is. And that's just my guess. I'm not exactly sure. I have no idea. But look out for those reviews in the future. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow me on Facebook. This has been Tambiota, and I'll see you guys next time.